component pressure loss. In this next section of the Quick Start video tutorial guide, we will be looking at adding a component object and the component screen. A system may include components such as a boiler, heat exchanger, or cooling coils with some flow versus pressure loss characteristics, and in Pipeflow Expert, we would often use a component object to model this data. We can add a component pressure loss by using this tool in the toolbar, or alternatively, let's click on a pipe where we want to add the component. We can then either click the Add Edit Component button on the pipe pane, or right click on the pipe and use the Add Component option to open the Set Component Pressure Loss screen. Let's open one of the existing components in this system as an example. We are given options to enter a component name and select an appropriate symbol. We can then choose how we want to define the data for this component, from a fixed loss, a curve loss, a CV or KV value, or we can model the data for specific sprinklers and orifices. So let's look at these options individually. Selecting the component type as a fixed loss allows us to enter a fixed pressure loss value, and this will apply regardless of the flow rate calculated in the pipe. Having one or two fixed loss components within the model is fine. However, we would usually recommend defining the flow versus pressure loss data using either a curve loss or a CV or KV value. This will allow the software to vary the pressure loss based on the flow rate in the pipe. This boiler component was modeled choosing the curve loss option. This allows us to enter the flow versus pressure loss data for a component to create a characteristic curve that will then be used in the calculation. CV and KV flow coefficients are often used to specify the flow versus pressure loss performance of a particular closed balancing valve, but the component object can be used to model any item using a CV or KV flow coefficient value. By definition, a CV flow coefficient specifies the volume of water in US gallons per minute at 60 degrees Fahrenheit that produces a 1 psi pressure loss across the valve or component. A KV is the metric equivalent to a CV and specifies the volume of water in meters cubed per hour and at 20 degrees Celsius that produces a 1 bar pressure drop. On the component screen, when the CV or KV option is selected, a calculator button is available to allow an appropriate CV or KV value to be obtained from a single point of flow and pressure loss. For example, let's enter a flow rate of 60 litres per minute for a 0.65 metre loss. The KV value is then calculated. The next option for modelling the component pressure loss is a sprinkler K value. Manufacturers of spray nozzles often publish sprinkler K values, which describe the flow rate divided by the square root of the pressure loss through the nozzle. The imperial sprinkler K is calculated from US gallons per minute and the loss in PSI. The metric sprinkler K value is calculated from flow in litres per minute and the loss in bar. Pipeflow Expert also contains a sprinkler K calculator for both imperial and metric values. Sprinkler K values for imperial and metric units are not interchangeable. A combination of a component and an impression node may be used to model the performance of a spray nozzle. As in this water mist example, which has a total of 36 high pressure water mist nozzles based in a warehouse. In this example, we have modeled each nozzle component alongside an impression node set to 0 PSIG. This models the spray discharging to atmosphere. The last component type offered within the software component screen are orifices. Pipeflow Expert provides support for sharp, round, bevel, and thick-edged orifices. When each orifice is selected, a relevant diagram describing the data required for that orifice calculation is included. For example, for round-edged orifices, the user is required to specify the rounding radius. For bevel orifices, the bevel thickness and angle is required. And for thick-edged orifices, we need to enter the plate thickness. The component orifice screen includes a helper where you can specify the flow rate at some inlet pressure and the required pressure drop. An appropriate orifice diameter D0 value will then be calculated. In addition, there is an option that allows the software to automatically size the orifice for a particular flow rate when the whole system is calculated. In this case, the orifice diameter is automatically calculated such that it produces the required pressure drop in order to achieve the specified flow rate in the pipe. This is when considering all other flows and pressure losses throughout the system. The details of the orifice calculation can then be viewed by clicking on the component. From this screen, we can see that the orifice has been sized to 1.378 inches for the 79.25 US gallons per minute flow rate we entered. It has also been calculated that this orifice will produce 9.05 feet of pressure loss. Returning to design mode and reopening the component pressure loss screen, we can see that any component pressure loss created in the Pipeflow Expert software can be saved to a standalone file, which can then be loaded into different Pipeflow Expert models, or even sent to another user, where the component could be used in one of their designs. Thanks again for watching. In the next video, we'll be taking a brief look at modeling pumps in the Pipeflow Expert software.